Hello, I'm Beat Feller. I've been a driver with the Swiss MOB Railway for 22 years. It's June 2000 and today my friend Alan, whom I've known for more than 15 years, will travel with me to shoot video. First, we will ride through the Upper Sima Valley to Lenk. Then, in the evening, we shall go over our main line to Montreux.
Regionalzug nach St. Stephan, Lenk.
We're riding in the control trailer of a local train powered by a 5000 series motor coach. There's a small first class saloon. This is refurbished second class. Rather nicer than before the change.
Blinking signal says somebody want to enter the train. It's a stop on radio station. Blankenburg. Nächster Halt auf Verlangen, Stöckli.
The forest ahead is now cleared of trees blown down in the hurricane of December 1999. The constant tick-tock sound comes from the tachograph or recording speedometer. We're doing 80. That's 50 miles an hour.
Berkeley. Next halt auf Langen, St. Stephan.
That was the vigilance alarm. It sounds if the driver has made no movement of any of the controls during a period of 30 seconds. When the alarm sounds, the driver has 4 seconds to respond by moving any control or by pressing a special pedal. If he doesn't, train power will be cut and emergency braking applied. Our motor coach is named after this village. Or in English, don't speak to the driver. But he also sells tickets when the station is unstaffed. The flashing orange light assures the driver that the equipment at the next level crossing is operating to protect his train.
Boden.
It's a request stop. No one wants to board on the night, so we might fly. The line ends almost 8 miles from Zimmern. Just outside the station are connecting buses to more remote places. It's a Bern-Lerchberg Simplon station. Their predecessor arrived in 1902, over 2 years before the MOB.
We are about to travel from Zweisimmen over our main line to Montreux.
We'll be riding on a 1400 horsepower 6000 series loco, introduced in 1983. The Swiss take brake tests very seriously. All MOB power units are fitted with a magnetic train stop system to prevent overrunning signals. On taking over, a driver must note the number shown on the counter and sign for it. Any operation of the train stop system must be accounted for. The driver also checks there's enough paper in the tachograph to last the journey. Here's the connecting train from Lenk. When passengers have transferred, it'll be time for us to go. Across the valley is Blankenburg village. Mosbach Tunnel was enlarged a few years ago to take standard gauge wagons on MOB's meter gauge transporter bogies. We turn flew about 180 degrees to continue climbing back above Zweisimmen. As we come to the loop at Halten, we look down past our starting point at Zweisimmen. Turning west now, towards the descending sun, we pass under the cables of the Winterberg Gondelbahn, or small cabin lift. The advance warning sign for a 40 km per hour temporary speed restriction, which starts here. We meet the Golden Pass Panoramic, the MOB's prestige train. The driver's in a rooftop lookout so that some passengers may have an unobstructed front view. The loco is sandwiched in mid-train. Dahnenmoser Tunnel also has been enlarged in profile. At 4,180 feet, this station is the highest point on this line.
schön riecht.
This station is noted for its colourful garden in front of the substation, whose motor generator sets convert the high voltage supply into 850 volts DC for the contact line. The opposing train is hauled by a 1200 horsepower articulated twin unit of the 4000 series. It dates from 1968. In the siding on our left, a train of conveyor-equipped spoil wagons waits to join the nearby overnight engineering works. One of MOB's newest 8000 series locos is attached.
Sonnen.
Our loco has force ventilated motors. The fans run continuously, even during intermediate stops. Tank wagons of aviation fuel. A regular freight is containerized refuse from this transfer station. The containers on standard gauge flat wagons ride to Zweisimmen on meter gauge transporter bogies. There they are handed over to the BLS line. Along this section, we leave Canton Bern, where a German dialect is spoken, for French-speaking Canton Vaud. More gear for tonight's works.
Flandru.
Thank you.
It's downhill along here, so the motors are in dynamic braking mode, generating current which is returned to the overhead line. This heats the motors, so the fans work harder and more loudly. But you'd hardly notice this in the coaches. Flashing white lights. Someone is waiting at the next stop. Parked in the station forecourt, this bus will convey the driver and passengers of our return train past tonight's engineer's occupation of the line between here and Rougemont. This isolated station, now unstaffed, has had its loop converted to a little used siding. These things happen in Switzerland too. another engineer's train.
Consigner. Latin.
Just here, we pass into Canton Fribourg. The language remains French. Work is in progress along here to replace the original timber poles with steel supports for the overhead wiring. Note the new concrete bases waiting for the new masts. Some more hurricane damage. A 6000 series loco like ours. This one was repainted in Crystal Panoramic livery. This is a GFM station. Their predecessor arrived first by 71 days. GFM line to Bulle is directly ahead of us, down the village street.
Lessier.
The hurricane damage here still awaited attention. Another natural disaster a few years ago saw the predecessor of the little chapel on the left swept away by a landslide. A nearby farmhouse was also destroyed, sadly, killing the farmer. The loop here has recently been considerably lengthened. In the siding is the engineer's maintenance train for the Jaumont tunnel, which we are nearing.
Lickers.
We turn to enter the 1.5 mile tunnel under the Col de Jaumont. This tunnel gives the MOB a considerably shorter route to Montreux than by road.
This is the steepest gradient on our line, 7.3%, and that's one in 13.7 in your system. In autumn, when some of these trees drop their leaves, I need great care with the brake when coming down. We have these problems too. Les avant.
From here, we must descend 1,880 feet to meet federal standard gauge at Montreux. Below, our first glimpse of Lac Léman, or Lake Geneva. Can you spot the name board, apparently on a tree on the left, for this very minimal stopping place? High across the valley, like a castle, stands a hotel at Caux. It's close to the Rochedenay Rack line. The upper end of Lac Léman is now seen distantly. Somewhere there is Le Bouveret, where there's a very popular 7.25-inch gauge railway and miniature land. We're on a continuous downgrade now, all the way down to Montreux. Those fans are working hard to keep the motors cooled in regenerative mode. Here we meet the upper end of the Blanet-Chambet Museum line. Depending on volunteers, it generally operates only at weekends. Can you see Montreux far below? This is the second of four U-turns on the descent. By this snaking, the gradient is kept to about 1 in 15.4, or 6.5%. The line was, of course, built for electric operation. The lake shore towards Vevey. From Montreux, you can ride there on a modern, environmentally friendly trolley bus. Thank you.
Cherney.
The MOB's workshops for overhaul and repair of all rolling stock. Every MOB wayside station has a local signalling panel as seen on the left. The track diagram indications may be seen through the window, but the controls are behind the locked door. This is the third U-turn on this descent. We cross the motorway which heads up the Rhone Valley towards Italy. The large hole in the loco's body is due to the baggage doors being open for filming. It's safer than it looks, there are strong bars across the openings. The mountains across the lake are the Alps of Haute-Savoie in France.
Colondal.
Like the highest U-turn at Chambly, the last of the four is in tunnel. One of the Golden Pass panoramic sets is in the second siding on our right.
Montreux.
The layout of the station float has been enlarged in recent years. The standard gauge siding, which formerly crossed the platform approach, has been eliminated. Under the elevated roadway on our right lies the terminus of the 80-centimetre gauge Rochedenay rack line. We have come 38.75 miles from Zweisimmen. Fiat's return working is the last through train to Zweisimmen, or it would be, but for the engineer's overnight work. It departs at 21:30, well after Montreux ticket office has closed, so before leaving, Fiat goes through the train, selling tickets to those without one. This train would normally be a 5,000 set, as on our ride to Lenk, but as the stock will only go part way, we have 3001, built in 1944. There's no MOB station staff here at this hour, and as this is a driver-only train, Bayat has to set the road for our departure. The 56-year-old 3001 is controlled by noisy contactors at the rear of the cab, but in the passenger saloon beyond the baggage space and vestibule, you'd not hear them.
Polish. Wallin.
Belmont.
Belmont. Golondal. Shatlov. Blanchon. Fontainebleau. Sonzier. Chambi.
Here's the last westbound flu train, a 30-year-old 4000 series twin unit. The boxy building ahead is a traction substation, housing modern power electronics.
Solar.
There are two later return trains as far as this next station, Les Avants, 1 hour later and 2 hours later than our last through service.
Les Avants.
The tunnel maintenance gang board here, they'll be working all night in the Jaman tunnel after we've been through.
Gas. Allier. Les Siennes.
The driver of the last one has to lock the waiting room.
When I walk this trip, it can feel like I'm the last one left working on the line. Mobile. Nothing. Rossinier. Château de
Transfers to and from the bus were much too rapid to allow for filming, so now we're in a similar 5000 unit to that in which we went to Lenk.
Sahnen.
Prominent ahead is the floodlit Palace Hotel.
Staat. Gruben. Schönried.
We resume more than two stations further on. The lights of Zweisimmen are far below.
Halten.
The horizontal line of orange lights below the signal warn that we will run into a partially occupied platform.
Zweisimmen.